Hi, this is David from Minute Earth. If you wanted to design the perfect predator, you'd make it huge, impossibly strong, incredibly fast, and capable of freezing its prey as it approached. And we've actually built pretty much that very thing, a car. And while cars aren't carnivores, every day they mow down millions of animals. And that doesn't even include insects. All this death, though, has an unexpected upside. The carcasses are actually a bonanza for scientists. Like, say you wanted to survey hedgehogs. Normally, you'd have to tromp through, well, hedges, night after night, maybe dragging along expensive equipment, just to find the elusive critters. And to gather information about individual hedgehogs, you'd have to use fancy traps and get special permits. Or you could just find them flattened on the pavement, document where you found them, gather the specimens, and study them to your heart's content. In fact, roadkill has actually helped us learn all sorts of stuff about our planet. Scientists in southern Europe have found more smushed snakes earlier and earlier in the spring, suggesting that the rising temperatures caused by climate change are drawing them out of their burrows sooner. In the Everglades, a sudden lack of wrecked raccoons, squashed opossums, and battered bunnies indicated that something was amiss. And that something turned out to be invasive pythons nomming all of the inhabitants of the swamp before they could even get to the road. And by studying the bowels of plowed owls, we found that pesticide-laden rats make up a large portion of the diet of many birds of prey, putting even non-squashed raptors at risk. But different animals don't all get flattened with the same frequency, right? Doesn't this make it harder to draw scientific conclusions from roadkill? Owls, for example, don't seem to notice cars, which makes them relatively common victims. Pronghorns, on the other hand, speed up when crossing the road, making them less likely to get hit, while bats detect and avoid traffic altogether. On the other end of the spectrum, armadillos tend to freeze when cars approach, so they're extra likely to get mowed down. And since scavengers like crows like to nom on flattened fauna, they often end up flattened too. But as long as scientists understand this variation, they can account for it in their analysis. Okay, so this is all a little morbid and a lot depressing, but roadkill ecologists are simply following in the footsteps of other opportunistic researchers, like marine biologists who search through fishing boat nets to find new deep sea dwellers, or engineers who study storm damaged structures to identify better building materials, or the archaeologists who excavate mass graves to reveal the mysteries of ancient civilizations, or even the astronomers who study the remains of star explosions to understand the laws that govern our universe. They're simply part of the grand tradition of scientists who turn carnage into knowledge. Ah, I never get tired of a good pun. And lately, we've really been able to step on the gas here at Minute Earth, thanks to your support. Because so many of you have recently become patrons at patreon.com/MinuteEarth, we've been able to ride out some major budget tightening by sponsors, and even start moving forward with a few new projects. And because our patrons have done so much for us, we're doing even more for you. We're doing regular giveaways of our new merch, and we've just launched a new behind-the-scenes talk show to show you how we make Minute Earth. Come and watch the first one over at patreon.com/MinuteEarth. And if you've got a few extra bucks and you think we're doing good stuff, consider becoming a patron. That would be killer.